JFK did his thing 50 years ago today.
His head explode?
No. You know, that's November 22nd, 1963.
Wow, yeah.
It's the Ich bin ein Berliner, or whatever.
Ich bin ein Berliner.
Do that
we thing. Will go to the moon and do those other things.
Right. It's like how about the moon you, and those other things.
How about you finish your fucking quote? And those other things.
By the end of the decade, we will go to the moon and well, that other shit.
Right. He needed Rich Voss to pump up that
line.
Yeah,
punch it up.
That's what I do. Absolutely. Voss was in high school then. He was available.
Right. Kennedy's fucking big quote there trailed off a bit.
Yeah.
How are you, Rich?
I'm pretty good. I haven't been here in months, man. It's good because, you know, you build up self-esteem
over
a couple of months.
Oh, and then
things happen. Good thing. Then you go, oh. And you come in, you go, oh, right back to
right.
Worthless,
let me just
nothing.
Now we're
throw the self-esteem right away.
You know, you just when things are going well.
Now we turned over a new leaf, man. Ask Sam Roberts. We're a much more positive show.
Yeah,
it's a whole new fucking Opie and Anthony. You're looking
is
at
it?
Yes, Sam. They got, tell them
they got girl interns.
Uh-huh.
So now they treat the two girl interns like human beings.
Really nice.
Is that a tattoo or?
Oh boy.
That? What the fuck is that?
Way to go, ADD.
Oh, man.
Wow, something shiny.
Is that a pinwheel?
Wow. Jesus, Rich. He's explaining something to you.
Yeah.
Wow. Is that a tattoo?
That tattoo?
Yes, it's
wow.
A
wow. That coin is shiny.
Okay, first of all, because...
Yeah, are we ever going to get to the
nice
second
one? Women now, interns, because what's going on?
It is a tattoo, yeah.
Oh, let's get back to the interns. You have two women, two female interns?
Yeah. You met the one. She was just in here. That you asked her if she's ever been in a BMW.
Yeah. Well, how? Because she's definitely too old for Anthony, but.
Oh,
what?
Jesus.
She's on the cusp.
Yeah.
She's got about a year left in Anthony's world.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Oh, Anthony's right here.
Once
sorry.
That graduation gown goes on.
Right. That's not true at all.
We have nothing in common.
That's not true. I'm with a high school graduate right now.
At least one of you is.
Boy.
So you're working on the Chris Rock movie. That's pretty exciting.
Yeah, it was good. You know, it's... The script, I had the script, you know, like 3 weeks ago, and it's good. That's, you know, I wasn't playing golf. My golf game was out the window, so I just sat and worked on the script. And, you know, we'll see what gets in. They do so many different takes, you know, when they're when they're doing these things.
Yeah, we...
It takes forever, right?
We filmed 40 minutes yesterday, and we're not stupid. We know we'll be in the film maybe for 5 to 10 seconds.
No, you'll be... No, because that scene is a crucial scene, the whole radio thing. You know, it'll be a montage.
They did
sure.
cancel 10 other shows, though, because they went long with us.
Yeah.
We just got that info from somebody.
You're
there's a lot of pissed off people around here.
Fucking great.
That was fun.
It was great.
That was good.
We'll see.
It's so good you get to play yourselves.
Yeah. No script. It was so great. No script.
No
to have to fucking memorize.
Learn.
It was fun.
Oh.
And the good thing is, because, I mean, I've seen you. You're all horrible actors.
Yes.
I'm a very good actor.
I'm a terrific actor, too.
Jimmy was talking to himself. It's okay.
Okay, good.
He's just talking amongst himself.
Fucking over actor.
I was great as a security guy in Joe DeRosa's little short film.
Oh, right.
Huh?
That's right.
That's right.
You were?
Yeah, I'm a terrific actor.
Next week, I'm a game show host on Amy Schumer's show.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Next week.
Wow. Mm-hmm. She put everybody in that.
Every single... Oh, you're not in there, Rich?
No,
oh, boy.
She's not a big Rich Voss fan.
No?
Okay. That's okay.
Why wouldn't she be? What does she have, ears?
come on.
I saw yesterday I was in the building, and I'm going to take a piss.
It's nice language.
Fucking Jeff Ross walks in, and so uncomfortable. He's like, hey, and I'm like, ugh, why are you talking to me?
Jeff
Whoa,
Ross?
Oh, you have a problem with Jeffrey? Jeff,
we were fucking, like, best of friends, you know, I mean.
Yeah,
I've written,
from the same tribe.
I've written probably on 7 roasts. We wrote on a roast, 2 or 3 roasts together. With
me and Rich, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't even think we barely got paid for the MTV one we did.
I remember.
I've written on tons of roasts for him. stuff that was quoted in the newspaper for me.
Oh,
I could tell
but
you.
But he got the credit.
But he got credit.
Of course, but it,
that's fine if you write that.
That's your job, writing. Sure,
but that's still got that still has to be a little frustrating.
You think when he did the burn, I'd get a fucking call?
Right.
After two, even to say, hey, look at Comedy Central pass on you, which I can't see that happening because I've done so much.
Sometimes the networks will say no, though. Like even though he's the guy, there's times where he might want to do something where they just go, no, we have to get this one and this one.
Wow.
There are times where the network will just overpower you.
I could see that.
He didn't watch you on the show.
I could see that the first, but the second.
Yeah, he didn't watch you on the show. It's obvious.
Well,
I'm a Rich.
After you've done so much for somebody,
right.
And you know when he first started comedy, I took him under my wings. He'd come to my house for dinner and stuff. And,
oh, wow.
You know, and it's not cool. Even that. Even if let's even say Comedy Central said no, he could mm-hmm. call and say, hey, look, man,
yep.
I want you on the show, but I can't. Yep. You know what I mean?
Sure, just let you know.
So, and you know, it's just all the shit you wrote.
So how'd it go yesterday when you saw him?
Yeah.
It was so uncomfortable. Like, hey, what are you doing?
I'm so he knows.
I'm
he
going
knows.
To take a piss. Well, I saw him in L.A. when I go, what the fuck? I'm not doing, you know.
What did you say?
Boy. Oh, you did ask him. Okay.
The first season.
And what did he say?
He goes, oh, yeah, I'm pushing for you or whatever. And, you know what? Go fuck yourself. Every time you needed something,
that's
you
a fake push
answer. Wow.
You call, you know. Ooh. Even if I wasn't right and I had to read his fucking bullshit, you know, how do you like this or how do you like that? Or you know, and Norton, too. Norton gets that kind of stuff because he knows how to do a roast.
Comics don't normally attack each other like this.
I'm not attacking him. I'm
do you think that he wasn't pushing for you, though? Because he does like you a lot, and he does think you're really funny, so why wouldn't he? Maybe he did push for you.
I don't. Then why wouldn't
he probably thought you
say,
weren't right for a show.
What? For the burn?
Yeah.
How am I not
that's
right
That's what I'm
for
saying. Of course. Oh. That's why it's crazy. I'm on your side.
Oh, okay.
I don't think he was pushing for you.
You do or don't?
Won't.
Well, you know what it is?
It's his show. He could have said, look, we're going to figure out how to get him on.
Listen, he put Ralphie on, and Ralphie's a draw in clubs. Don't get me wrong. He's a big act in club. Ralphie sells out theaters.
I like Ralphie,
okay?
Man.
Okay, yeah, he sells out theaters. He's a good friend, nice guy. But it's not like...
yeah, Ralphie May. I like him.
Yeah, he's big.
You know, he's very funny. But... It's not like he's a TV star. I mean, I can see when you're going with Amy,
leading man.
Who's on TV, or Jeselnik, who have shows on Comedy Central.
Yeah, of course.
I could see that. You know,
yeah.
Fucking Norton has, you know, a resume as long as...
I get nothing. I was on Jeff's show once. I was happy to do it, but nah.
You have a great resume.
Are your feelings hurt, Rich?
No, yeah.
You're on Jeselnik?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Yeah, because
fair
the
enough.
Thing is, yeah, it's not, it's like, you know what, just a call. You called me many times when you had fucking roasts. Hey, how about this?
You never called me, Tony. Tony, you never called me. Hey, get off the bridge, right?
I probably wouldn't even have done this show.
You would have.
No, I wouldn't.
I got Shep Blue Miles. That's okay. I know what you mean. Rich is right. Your feelings get hurt. It happens.
You
it
know,
does. Fuck yeah.
People, you know, that's all right. I try to help out my friends as much as I can. That's what I do. That's what I do now. You try to help out your friends, that's all.
I know. That seems to be a big thing in comedy, and if it doesn't happen, there's a fucking wrath. Hell to pay.
So you know what? Some people, you know, it's just all about them.
Right.
You know, they fucking... You guys have comics in here all the time.
All the time,
we do.
Because you can
not today,
do
but
20
all
hours.
The time.
Oh, Jesus.
No, you know what, though?
What
a writer today.
Having comics in, it's like I got to a point where I was like, I said, fuck comedians. I was so disgusted with comics for a while. Because so many of them, like, I very rarely ask for anything. And then when you ask for one little thing... There was sometimes the response you get from people, even if they can't do something, it's okay.
Yeah.
But the lack of response once in a while, I'm like, just fuck these cunts. Fuck them.
Mm.
Why help comedians? I know that they're good for the show.
Yeah.
But like, I'm not going to say don't have comics on. But there was a while where I'm like, I'm not going to push for any comedians. I'm not going to protect them when they fuck it. You just get to that point where you're just like, you know,
yeah.
People are just disloyal.
As people. Right. Hey, the second you call me about that thing that you didn't do, right away, I said yes. You know, that's what we do. When we asked Norton to do our sizzle reel. He fucking, you know. I mean, it's not like he's got anything else happening.
Exactly. Believe me, I was available. I said yes before you gave me the date. You said, are you available? I went yes.
I don't know how that show was not fucking picked up.
Because I'm telling you, everything I touch dies, bro.
Oh.
That's not true.
It dies on the vine.
That's not true.
It absolutely is true.
There's 10,000 working cocks in this city. It doesn't die. It, whatever. You know, I'm Perry positive lately.
Yeah,
good for
not
you.
Not at all. Fucking.
She was talking about HIV.
Yeah. I just wish his name was Perry. I like the idea of being Perry Voss.
Where are you gonna be, Voss?
Oh God! Saturday, Mohegan Sun. I'm doing a casino at Mohegan. Well, Friday's Marissa's, but Saturday at Mohegan Sun.
Oh, man.
Then the following weekend at Hartford Funny Bone.
Mm.
You know. Mohegan Sun, go up there, play some golf at those courses.
Oh, yeah?
Did you watch the U.S. Open?
Yeah, I did.
Watch a little bit of that.
Pissed off.
That's a tough course, man. It's a shitty course.
What do you, it's a shitty course. It's great when they don't shoot fucking 17
when you're talking
under par.
I don't want 17 under par, but when you're talking about a course where not one pro golfer is under par for the tournament, that's a shitty course in the end. Stop bragging about it.
You don't think it's a tough course?
It's a tough course, but it's a shitty course.
Oh.
I hope he wasn't very happy with the course.
No, don't you think?
I don't
know. One golfer should be under par for the tournament.
Well, the first year...
Or it gets ridiculous.
The first year at Bethpage at the Open, Tiger shot one under, and he was the only one.
Well,
he was at one under.
This is going to bore people, but the U.S. Open, they're known for picking really tough courses and making the conditions ridiculous.
Mm.
What was the one out in the Hamptons? Shinnecock or whatever it's called? I went out for that. I went out for that tournament. I watched a par 3 hole for 2 hours. It was an uphill. They were, I don't know, they might have been hitting 5 irons, 4 irons, probably 5 irons. Not one fucking guy could get the ball on the green. Every single shot rolled off the green, giving them really tough fucking chips. It was impossible. They made it impossible where you could not land it on the green.
Tough
That's
chips.
When it starts getting
What's that?
That's when it starts getting ridiculous.
Welcome to golf tour.
I know.
Well,
what about Phil Mickelson real fast and we'll move on.
No, the guy this weekend that won, the Travelers, 44-year-old, has never won a tournament.
The Travelers? Because no one played that tournament.
Yeah, the Bubba Travelers.
Ross, a lot of them played.
A
Justin
few
Rose
did.
Played.
Terrible.
The winner from the Open played. You know, there was like 10 major things.
All right,
it came
enough.
Down to a playoff. It came down to a playoff, and a 44-year-old guy won who's never won. And there's no better feeling than seeing the underdog.
What about Mickelson choking again?
Who cares? He's overrated. They just needed somebody to compete with Tiger back in the day, so they go...
Do you think he's a choke? Mickelson?
Yeah,
I mean, he's won
rough.
3 Masters, but I mean...
Did he win 3?
Yeah. Mm. He won 3 Masters.
It's pretty rough, though. He just can't figure out that U.S. Open. He comes in second. That's the 6th time, I think, right?
Yeah.
That's brutal.
How about Vijay Singh?
Oh, he's done.
He's done? Yeah,
he's pretty much ready for the senior tour.
Wow.
He's going to move,
funny,
he's gonna
no
move on.
Names.
What about the shark?
Oh, my God.
Greg Norman?
What about Greg Norman?
Do you know how much money he makes from his clothing line and all his restaurants?
With dumb shark clothes, yeah.
He was married to the tennis player for a few minutes.
Chris Everett. And then it went horribly bad.
All Chris Everett Lloyd?
Yeah.
Money attracts money.
Hey, you know what? Sammy. Sammy Hagar.
How
old is Sammy? He's like fucking 1,000 years old.
He
still
great.
Looks like Sammy Hagar.
Holy fuck, he hasn't aged at all.
It's amazing.
He's on Imus right now. I guess he's in Best Of, right?
Yeah, he's in Best Of, but this can't be all that old.
He's 65.
Wow.
Get out of here.
Sammy's 65. He looks like fucking Sammy Hagar.
Dude, he looks
from
great.
Years ago.
He's 65 years old?
He's still got like the curly blonde hair thing going. That should just be gray.
He used to
and
do our
gone.
Show.
Sammy.
What happened to Sammy Hagar? He used to do our show.
Oh, no.
I don't think we were too kind on his new music.
What?
Chicken Foot?
Chicken Foot was a little rough.
Oh, it's very...
65, heading towards 66.
Amazing.
He's 65 and a half.
Sammy Hagar was in Van Halen for a little while.
There you have it.
Yes.
And we're all there Team Roth now, man. David Lee Roth is now officially a friend
David
of this
Lee
radio
Roth.
Show. We love him.
Yeah.
He's out of his fucking mind, but we love him.
Wouldn't.
Huh?
Is he with Van Halen,
who wouldn't?
Too?
He's sort of with Van Halen right now, yeah.
Wasn't there a controversy during the induction into the Hall of Fame with a band?
Yeah,
I'm not really
up
on that
They stuff. Don't really like each other. That's what it is.
Long history.
It got a little, got a little ugly.
But there I know. That's okay.
Oh, we got a very good question coming in. Or an observation for Rich Voss. Thank you, Mike, on Long Island.
Mike?
Talk to Rich.
Hey, Rich. Just wondering, why are you bitching about not being on TV with somebody when you were just on Tattoo Nightmares? You could have cracked a couple jokes there getting your tattoo fixed.
Oh.
We did. Well, let me explain
to you. Did you crack some
here.
Jokes?
Yeah, let me explain something to you. And that's a great question. Thank you for the call.
Oh, wow.
Let me explain TV to you.
You know, you tape for 5 hours, but you know what? And then you're done. You're not in the editing room, so you really don't know what they're going to edit, being they're not a comedy show. They're a tattoo show. So, yeah, of course.
Well, that's your mistake.
No, it's not my mistake.
You should perform for only 5 minutes, giving them only 5 minutes of material in the editing room. Why would you give them 5 hours?
Well, because
we learned the hard way with that stupid-ass Bill O'Reilly. We gave him so much shit, and then they edited the fuck out of it, made us look like just fucking sex fiends.
Well, the thing is, because the tattoo.
That fucking
sex fiend.
Remember, we had some intelligent conversation going on that day. He
sex.
That all went on the editing floor.
Well, but the thing is, the tattoo.
They had an agenda.
Took 4 to 5 hours, so I'm not going to sit there like a mind that you got to talk.
No, don't say anything. And then just give them a couple really good lines, and then that's what they're going to use.
Well, Bonnie said some great stuff, and I think they used one line I used that was pretty good. But you know, thanks for the call and thanks for watching. Hey,
Rich, where's your tattoo that they covered up?
Right here.
What was it again?
It was a tribal piece.
Yeah, now it's just a.
It's flowered. It's got to get touched up again a little.
Were they gonna recolor it?
Yeah. I mean, because
it's a bit blotchy.
It was a cover up over a cover up. I said this tattoo.
You're pretty much a black. Like the Obama administration.
I said there's more cover ups than Benghazi.
Oh.
That was one of the jokes I did on the tattoo show.
That's a little political for our show.
Yeah. We're not very happy with the
too political for fans.
This is a good fucking. This is good. I mean,
I know he said Benghazi like it was a guy named Ben.
Benghazi.
Oof. But that tattoo show, they've played like 20 fucking times. I get more people come up to me from a tattoo show than some, you know, Comedy Central.
I see it on
special.
Twitter all the time. People are like, hey, check out Rich Voss is on the tattoo show. I'm like, I know, I've seen it.
How many people are in a vegetated state where they're just sitting
in this
there
room?
let me see your tattoo. What does that mean?
It's Jack White's autograph. And then that's Rob Zombie's autograph above it.
But that's not a real tattoo. That's just marker.
No.
Yeah, no, I got him to sign it a year ago, and then I just haven't.
Wait, listen to me, you fucking groupie douchebag. You fucking jackass. Because you signed your fucking. You're just one of a million people that has somebody's name signed on them, and they're fucking B-list actors.
God, B-list actors?
They're not actors.
Jack Black?
Oh, God.
You got the wrong color.
Oh, it's Jack White.
It's White. I
mean, whatever.
And I said,
he's a B-list.
Do you know who
actor.
Jack White is?
Huh?
You know who he is?
A jackass tattooed on his arm.
Oh.
No, I don't know. Who is he?
do you know Rob Zombie?
Yeah.
Okay.
Rob Zombie's a guy you used in your TV show, didn't you?
No.
To play the music?
I was Lemmy.
Well, whatever.
Oh, wow.
Same type of guy.
Very different.
Well, whatever. Rom Zombie. He's a,
I don't know who Rom Zombie is.
Rom Zombie. Rom Emanuel Zombie.
I think he said Zombie.
Rom Zombie.
Rom Zombie.
Okay, but. Oh, Jesus. You and Joe fucking
God,
just sit around.
Do you like DeRosa's tattoo?
Huh?
DeRosa's tattoos are good.
Well, yeah. What is it? A fucking Carlin quote? Yeah. It should have been. Quit comedy.
Every time you see it, it looks like he wrote kitten on his arm.
It should have been.
It looks like kitten.
Yeah, it does look like kitten.
Straighten up bookend.
Well, the problem with the tattoos is it's KKTITN. Keep kicking them in the nuts because Carlin said that to him. The problem is that Joe used all capital letters, then they put a period at the end of it. And you should never put a period at the end of a tattoo.
Oh. And you should never have a tattoo that starts off with KK, because if that's all you see, you think he's in the fucking Klan.
Yeah, you think all of a sudden he got saved after the second K? Like a black guy walked by who Joe's like, he's a nice fella. No, no, forget this idea.
Yeah, don't put that there.
KK trucking.
It is, look like kitten.
Huh?
I see kitten every time. Every time my dumb brain.
It looks like it's kitten. Yeah.
What now?
It's just horrible.
You don't like Sam's tattoo?
No, it's fucking horrible. Because he wants to have something in life that has meaning to him and grasped. You know what I mean? Look, I put my kids on my arm because they're my kids, okay? Not to say play in a garage.
Have a cover-up of a cover-up of a cover-up.
Not because they play in a garage band, okay?
Oh, God.
Well, Jack White did start in his garage, so.
Okay. All right.
I'm fairly successful beyond that, but...
How about you got to train... To change your transmission. Are you going to put that on the other arm?
Frank Thompson.
Yeah, Frank, he gave me a good deal on a new transmission.
That's fucking idiot. Funny. All right, that's good.
Sam, you're not going to win, by the way.
Frank Thompson.
Who's that? Yeah. Changed my transmission.
This is Rich as shit. You're not going to win.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
We all know not to go down this road with Rich.
We've toyed about his tats in the past. Yeah.
Toyed? You know. You should have cut off his arm. And toyed with it.
Wow, it's two tattoos, right?
Oh, yeah. And then Rob Zombie's logo is above it. That's three.
Oh, okay.
And you have such good, horrible, you know, no pigment skin where a tattoo would look so good on you.
A tat is very
good.
Yeah,
you could do a lot of colors, Sam. You do have light skin, but you just go with the dark.
Yeah, black fucking signatures. Yeah.
I would get Ozzy on my arm, though.
Would you?
Not at this point in my life, but
why
I would
not?
Have.
Why not at this point?
Nah, because I'm too old to do it.
Yeah?
Yeah, you're not too old.
But it's such a part of your life. Nah, you know, Ozzy's a big part. Yeah. Now you know him and shit.
Yeah, that's why I can't.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
that would be creepy if he saw it.
And you'd show
Ozzy,
him.
Ozzy, look, I got a tattoo.
Brand new.
Ozzy, look, I got a tattoo.
Look what I got, Ozzy.
I got your name.
A little something.
On my arm.
Makes us closer.
Yes. Yeah.
What's wrong, Rich?
What, fucking buddy? Food, my food.
What'd you order, buddy?
Doesn't matter.
What'd you get? Come here.
Huh?
What'd you
what get? Happened?
What, I ordered a Rom Zombie sandwich.
Rom Zombie.
Who's Rom Zombie?
It's Rob's brother.
Who's getting Rich's food?
Eric interns.
Which hopefully one? Dr. Kevorkian.
Which one?
Which intern?
Tyler and Sal went down.
Fucking assholes.
Oh, fucking assholes.
Who?
Tyler?
Who's that?
Who's sorry, she? Rich.
Who, hey,
Tyler.
Don't
sorry
tell him
about
who
that
it is. He'll tattoo the name on his arm. He's my favorite intern here.
Oh, shit.
A lot of people sometimes put their wife, maybe.
That's true.
You know?
Yeah.
I see my wife every day.
Huh? Wow.
My wife's already in my life. I don't need to tattoo her.
Oh.
But if you're tattooing names, yeah, maybe you should do someone in your
close to you.
Yeah.
You know. I mean, I'm sure those guys call you all the time. You know, did they do your show after theirs? Do they come on your show?
No.
Okay, there's a reason to tattoo their name. Here's two more people that won't come on my fucking show.
Oh.
Tattoo Who Kid and Bobby Kelly on, like, back to back on my back.
They come on.
I had a guy tattoo my name on his ass. It was really weird. He got me to sign his ass. He goes, I'm going to tattoo it. And as a joke, I signed it. I never thought he would do it. And he came back. I have a photo of it somewhere. He got my fucking name on his cheeks.
How can you get? How can you get a white pearly fucking tattoo? And make it look like it's dripping like that.
I just happened to retweet a guy that did my name on his chest.
I just saw that. Wow.
What kind
Jesus.
Of,
why
I signed this guy's chest. He tattooed
that's
it.
Fucked up.
I'm getting a new piece in a couple of weeks right here, but.
You wish you could get a new piece.
So do I.
I know. I said you wish you could get a new piece, and you said, so do I.
I thought you meant ass. Oh,
no, I thought you said I need a new piece, Spider-Man.
I feel bad because I didn't sign my name that good for him.
I can't even believe
I fucked up my own signature. He had to tattoo it that way.
Who is that psychopath?
I know, he doesn't even look like an O&A listener.
Well, yeah.
I fucked it up. He's still tattooed it.
That's terrible.
I don't sign like that.
It's not even.
I was tired, I think.
And it's not even like horizontal.
No.
It's like it's tilted too much.
But thank you anyway.
Your tattoo is his chest. He has no chest.
Yeah, I don't think he has a nipple. Does he have a nipple? Man.
It's probably down low.
Yeah, it's probably a little bit higher up.
Yeah.
Flabby.
What else is going on with you, Rich? You got to be on the movie set soon. Where are you guys filming today?
In New York. at the Times building, I think.
Oh, cool.
Are you close? That's close.
What's that?
A couple blocks.
Yeah, I'll walk down there. That's what I do. You know, get a little exercise.
Yeah, get a little hair, you know.
Get a little exercise.
Oh.
I want to take. I feel like taking Opie and his wife out to dinner again. That's what I want to do.
Oh, look at that.
Why don't you take me out to dinner?
I'll take you out to dinner.
No, he's setting up a joke.
No, I'm not.
Are you setting up a joke?
No, I like.
I'll pay attention this time.
No, I won't.
But you were on your phone just as much as I was.
My phone's turned off. I wasn't on my phone at all. It's completely off.
I mean, when we went to dinner.
Oh.
Because the girl said that we were on our phones too much.
I wasn't. You were. Listen.
Isn't that annoying?
No, because I.
To be
I
told
want,
that.
I don't have funny mofos to send out.
You don't like that name, do you?
That's fucking horrible. I mean, I wouldn't tattoo it on my arm.
Boss just comes in, acts like a cocksucker for an hour and leaves.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, he's finally had it with us.
Yeah, yeah.
I like this version of him. I ain't taking your shit anymore. That's the Rich Voss we got now. Oh, we got Larry King coming in soon.
Yeah.
You want to meet Larry King?
Yeah. I saw him in the elevator.
Oh, yeah.
He doesn't look bad for 140.
He looks great.
Where is he going?
I can't believe he does our radio show. It's amazing.
All right.
I'm serious.
What's he got going on?
He was the big fucking guy at CNN forever.
Never came here.
The king of the interview.
But you're
and now we interview him.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Huge.
Well, that's a good point.
That's crazy if you think about it.
He's interviewed presidents.
Yeah. Yes, and then we sit here and ask him shit. That's weird, don't you think?
It's unbelievable. He interviewed presidents, and you had Lady Di this morning.
Yeah, right? Isn't that great?
I love her.
Oh, well, I'm not a president. I'm not a right.
Yeah.
Fucking
she answers
dolt.
Jokes. It's my favorite thing.
She's such a dolt.
She answers jokes.
Yeah.
Who does that on a regular basis? You might fuck up every once in a while, but... Why don't we take a break, and when we get back, Larry King will be here. You're sticking around, right, Rich?
Yeah, easily till 8:39. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Mohegan's on.
Just say it proper.
I thought you were off the air.
Who's on? Who's
no? Where are you going to be?
Oh, this Saturday I'll be at Mohegan's on. Friday I'll be in Marissa's. Thursday night in Red Bank somewhere. This Thursday Red Bank somewhere. But Friday Marissa's in Trumbull. Saturday, Mohegan Sun, and next weekend at Hartford Funny Bone.
So who's tattooed on his arm? I want to see if you can remember the names.
Rob Zombie.
Oh.
And who's the other one?
Huh?
And?
E-Rock. Danny. In tribute.
In tribute.
We're lucky to have Rich Voss in the studio today. I'll tell you that much.
Believe me. Good thing you turned the mics on. I had such a bad fucking evil joke to say about that. We were just talking about the money that Obama is going to use to go to Africa.
$100 million.
Yeah.
What happened?
He saved $90 million and went to Detroit.
Yeah.
He didn't spend $100 million to go there.
The cost is $100 million.
For how long?
Him and his family to go to Africa.
It was $100 million?
Yeah, it might be less. It might be $60 million, $70 million.
They're trying to say that it's business, you know, that it's a business thing and it's not just a vacation. It's taking the whole family. They got safaris planned, or they canceled the safari, but they're still doing other things. But
he gets up there and says, "We all need to make sacrifices."
Exactly.
We'll follow your lead.
Yeah, they're furloughing
federal
employees.
Just because you're the president, maybe you should go, you know what, I would have spent $60 or $70 million going to Africa. But, you know, I'm asking the American families to sacrifice, so we're going to sacrifice this year and not do that.
Yeah.
We're going to go to Disney World.
They say it improves relations.
It's bullshit. He should only go to Camp David. They already have that. It's free.
You got a fucking vacation place, right?
I read that when they went on the safari last time, they have to hire, marksmen.
Yeah, just in case lions come after them.
Yeah, but Mark's a good guy, and the people he provides are worth it.
Oh, fuck.
Jim Chip.
But wait, Camp David... Yeah. I mean, they go up to, Nantucket or whatever, Cape Cod. They do that one.
Kennebunkport? That was the bush.
Kitty?
That was the original bush.
Yeah, but they always go up to the vineyard.
The
vineyard, you know, which is couldn't be any more waspy than anywhere on this planet. You know what I mean?
I hear you.
First of all, if he wasn't president, they probably would look who's, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
All right, don't, you know what I'm saying.
Well,
you know?
It's a lot of money to spend to go on a fucking vacation, the president, and they shouldn't in these difficult times be
I agree.
Spending all that money.
I agree.
And yeah, oh well.
Yes, of course, he decided to stay. Then it's worth every penny. I mean, really?
You don't like him?
I'm not a big fan of his policies and whatnot.
When are you going to speak out about it?
Nice enough guy.
It's about time you speak out about it. I think.
I think I have.
What policy are you? What policy?
Oh no, Rich! Please.
Oh, Rich! It's everything,
Rich.
It's all of his social policies that cost money and do nothing. It's this immigration reform. It's everything that I have no fucking use for. That just is pretty much destroying the country. I think it's there's a lot more he could be doing with the money. This economy doesn't seem to be really getting much better. The job situation that he promised, he in his first term he used the last president screwed everything up. Well, he could use that this term also. The last president screwed it up.
Is there a Democrat that you would like as president? Like if it?
You know what? I got to be honest with you. In hindsight, I think Clinton wasn't that bad. I mean, obviously some huge fucking problems, but. He did seem to know about business and that whole it's the economy stupid thing. You know, he kind of knew what it took to make to build the economy. You know, and a lot of these social programs and these bullshit fixes that the Obama administration wants to put in play, I don't think they help. And I don't like his stance on gun control. The second his fucking second term kicked in, you know, he left gun control alone, and then they caught him talking about how, in the second term, that's when things are going to kick in with the gun control, and everyone's like, oh, you're paranoid. Well, fucking days into his inauguration for his second term, he's fucking ripping guns away from law-abiding citizens. Enough.